Of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved ones, today is Monday, being the last day in the month of November. And today the Monday Church celebrates St. Andrew the Apostle. And being the Monday of the first week of Advent, year B. And readings will be coming from St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 10, verse 9 to 18. A responsorial psalm will come from Psalm 19, verse 5. A gospel message will come from Matthew Gospel, chapter 4, verse 18 to 22. The theme of our message today is called to preach the gospel. God has created all of us in his own image and has called us to go and proclaim the kingdom of God to the whole world. So the essence of calling out to himself is that we join him in proclaiming the kingdom of God on earth. So that's what he's doing for us today. And that's why today you can see Jesus in this effort to make sure he initiates us into this ministry. He was on the Sea of Galilee when he saw Simon, who is called Peter, with his brother Andrew. They were casting their net in the water because they were fishermen. And Jesus called them that he made them fishers of men. And they left everything and followed him. He had called them to a higher position. So they have to leave everything and follow Jesus. In the same way, he went forth and saw two brothers, James and John, the sons of Zebedee. They were in the boat and mended their nets with their father. And Jesus called them to follow him. And they left their father, left the boat and everything and followed him. Following him to continue the ministry of Jesus, the mission day, the mission of Christ to bring good news to the poor, to liberate people in bondage, to open the eyes of the blind, to let the oppressed go free and announce the year of God's favor. So that's the mission Christ came to implement and has invited some people, all of us, to join him in this ministry. So he has called the apostles, Simon Peter and Andrew, his brother, James and John today. And the mission is to go and preach the gospel of God, Christ. Because of this call, that's why Paul wrote to the Romans, if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe with your heart that God raised him up from the dead. Look at the two missions. If you confess with your lips that Jesus is the Lord, and believe with your heart that God raised him from the dead, you'll be saved. Remember, already there is a decree by God the Father that the name of Jesus, every knee must bow, every tongue must confess. In heaven, on earth, and under the earth. I can see in Philippians chapter 2, verse 9 to 11. So it's already a degree even. But we are called now to join that ministry. And he said, so if you confess with your lips, so you are saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him can be put to shame. It's just a standing rule. No person who believes in him can be put to shame on this earth. Because you become the salt of the earth and light of the, you become a more the Lord as we look upon. You can't be an object of shame. You can't be an object of ridicule anymore. You cannot be a basis of low culture because you're already in a high culture. So you can never be put to shame. Because when you come into the realm of the word of God, accepting the word of God, There is no Jew or Gentile. There is no racism, no tribalism when you are in him. So there is no discrimination. You become a universal personality. So God has called us to become universal personality. From our parochial way, from our racial point of view, from our tribal point of view, he has called us to universalism. Universal brotherhood and sisterhood. So that's what he has called them to do. And now what Paul is making us to know, that the Lord is the Lord of all and bestow his riches upon all those who call upon him. He pours his riches upon those who call upon him. There is no other way. It's that by you or him, you call upon his name. For you all who accepted him, he gave the privilege of being called the children of God. So any person who call upon him, he bestows the privilege. And he said, for all who call upon him from any language, God accepts. And anyone who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. The moment you begin to call upon the name of the Lord, you're already working your salvation. You'll be saved. Because you know his name. And the sheep that he sees knows him, and he knows his own sheep. And they follow him. They listen to his voice alone. I can see in John chapter 10, verse 4 and 27. So you can see when he calls you into himself, that you share in him. And the question comes up, said then, how can they call upon the name of the one who they don't know? How can you call upon the name of the person you never know? And how can you believe on him who you have never heard about? How can they hear without a preacher? How can you hear the word without someone preaching it to you? How can a preacher go without being sent? That's where the problem lies. A preacher must be sent, not you appointing yourself as a preacher. You must be called as Aaron was called. Not when your business fail, you become a man of God. When they sack you from your job because of your laziness and corruption, you say you become a man of God. When you cannot do little jobs, God will call you to a higher job. That is not God calling you. It's yourself calling yourself, and you are sending yourself. That will have false prophets. They were not called by God and not serving God. They are serving their personal interests. And that's why they have private jails and private universities. Now what is making all of us to know today, that you can't be a preacher. They can't have a preacher unless a preacher is sent to them. As is written, how beautiful is the feet of him who brings the good news. Look how beautiful the leg of the one who brings good news. Who will not accept good news? Unless you are possessed. And when you cannot accept the good news, it means you are 2020 years behind civilization. Our God is telling all of us today, we are called to go and preach this good news. And he said again, but they have not all heed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed what he has heard from us? Who has believed what we have heard from us? So faith comes from hearing. And what is heard comes from preaching of the gospel. Preaching of Christ. And somebody say, have they not heard? He say, indeed they have. They have. It made you hear the word, you have heard it. Even if you see the people who believe proclaiming, even without hearing them, you have seen the word. You have heard the word. Because their life based testimony to what they are preaching. Because their voice has gone throughout the earth. Their sound to the utmost end of the world.
No noise, but their word have gone all over the place.
And that's why, since we are called to proclaim this, you go on and proclaim this word. In season and out of season. You don't need to look on any person. You don't begin to ask whether they accept it or not. It's not necessary. Preach the word in season and out of season. Paul tells us. And that's why the disciples understood that we are called to go and preach this good news. And this news goes to the people through hearing. Faith comes from hearing. That's why the disciples said, their sons go forth throughout all the earth. Their sound goes for throughout the earth. How the word of God has gone all over the world. That you didn't accept it doesn't mean the word is not there. So we are called to go and preach the gospel. So if you are not going to preach today, go and preach. You preach by your thoughts, by your word and your action. Are you addressing? Are you association? It has to be holistic. Witnessing with your total life. Not only by word, but by your life. And your addressing and your association. And your conduct. And that's why today, the Mother Church celebrates St. Andrew the Apostle. One of those who were called to go and preach the gospel. We know about Andrew today in the gospel message, the brother of Simon Peter. He was formerly a disciple of John the Baptist. But when John the Baptist introduced Christ, this is the Lamb of God. Andrew left John the Baptist and followed Jesus. Remember the episode where he followed Jesus? He said, Master, where do you live? He said, come and see. And when he has gone, he went and brought his own brother. And he was the person with Philip who introduced the Gentiles to Christ. And we're told he preached the gospel in the Far East. And was crucified in an S-shaped cross in Greece. So we see Andrew playing some roles among the time in the ministry of Christ. And that's why the church celebrates it today as apostle. Because he was called to preach. And he preached and offered and witnessed for this word with his own blood. We ask God to give us the spirit of Andrew. Since God has called us to witness for this word in season and out of season. And proclaim it by everything, even to the extent of our blood, as Andrew did. We ask through Christ our Lord. May the blessings of Almighty God be on upon all of us. I will celebrate our call and our mission to proclaim the gospel of Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all. Look forward to see you again in this Resurrection Channel.